Seagull Models has released a newer version of their Yak 11 Reno Racer. The first version was the Perestroika, green and silver, and this new version has a new color scheme as well, race number 86, the blue and silver Czech Mate. I had told Tom at Legend Hobby a year ago that if they offered this plane in a Czech Mate scheme, I'd go ahead and get it, and sure enough they did, so I went ahead and ordered this from Legend Hobby. So let's get this box open. I'm going to show you all the pieces, parts that comes with this model, as well as all the updates from the previous version. So let's first open the box, and we can see that both wings are individually wrapped and on top of each other, and there's a separating board underneath the wings with the rest of the pieces. Let's take those wings out and look at the box, and we can see the fuselage, the horizontal stab, the control rods, the cowling. And so just give you an idea how this is packaged, we see the nice electric retracts from Seagull, and that separating board was actually an old Mugol box, so no doubt the Seagull Models, bring back the Mugol, update it and bring it back, I would buy one. So let's get one of the wings out, we will unwrap it and just show you this very nice pearl blue of the wings. And if you've watched the Perestroika build series, it's very similar. We see we have a spot for the aileron servo, a spot for the flap servos. We see the flaps and the ailerons are taped in there, and we have the pull-through wires to run your cables. So here's a nice little slow close-up just to give you a really good idea what the bottom of the wing looks like. And here we have the horizontal stab and elevators. Again, individually wrapped. We'll go ahead and unwrap these and pull this out. Very nice clean covering job, again with that really shiny pearl blue. Here is the vertical stab and the rudder and the attachment, how it attaches to the back of the fuselage. We'll just pull this out. And this right here was when I saw this chrome covering, and I was expecting gray. I wasn't expecting chrome, so that's really exciting. I'm looking forward to see that. Here's a slow panning shot of that horizontal stab so you can get a good idea of that pearl blue covering and what this looks like before we go ahead and install it. Here is that rudder and vertical stab, and you can see we will have to trim some covering before we epoxy that onto the rear of the fuselage. But again, really excited about that chrome covering. I was expecting gray, so excited to see the rest of the fuselage. Next we have the cowling. I'm now excited to see how this is because I know it's two-tone. The very front is gray, but this is packaged nice. We'll cut this wrapping off and we can see that it's wrapped with paper underneath. So let's pull this out of the bag. So this is really nice. We got this chrome look and the two-tone. We got the gray up front. That's looking good. We can look inside and see the fiberglass. So this is a really nice looking cowling. Very similar to the Perestroika, except for the color changes. So let's get into the accessories. Here is the electric motor mount. You can see here that this triangle stock comes with that to reinforce this movable plate that you can kind of adjust depending on what type of electric motor you get. So this is really nice. We use this on the Perestroika and we'll see if we need to use it here. Here are the bolts for the motor mount. Everything comes with it. And now let's open up the first new thing for this series is the cover over the tail wheel. Before it was a piece of plastic that you just screwed on, and now we have an actually built up piece that we'll have to attach. That's interesting. Let's pull out the canopy, which looks exactly the same as the Perestroika, just fits right on top. Very nice. And here's the big bag of nuts and bolts. We'll open this up and we can see it comes with a nice 35cc fuel tank. We got the pitot tube, we have the pilot, which I don't remember it being that heavy, but I'll have to go back. It has some weight to it, but we have the flap control horns, we have nuts and bolts, we have the painted control horns for the ailerons and flaps and rudder. We have the tail wheel, same as the old Perestroika. And what else do we got in here? The for a gasoline engine motor mount screws. And then a template, a drilling template for the firewall with some different options of what to drill for. Here we have the wing tube. It's nice and aluminum, very nice and lightweight, but looks really sturdy, so good on that. And here are the landing gear doors. Now, what's interesting is that if the wings are blue on Czech Mate, then the gear door should be blue, but they've covered these in the chrome covering. Probably to match the picture that's on the box, but we can talk about the different Czech Mate schemes later on. But here are the gear door covers, very similar to the green ones that came with Perestroika. They have a little weight to them, so they're nice and sturdy. Here's two new things to this kit. These are both the rubber tires and the aluminum hub wheels, 3.5-inch wheels that come with it. So these are definitely an upgrade from the previous version. And there is a decent amount of give on these tires, not the super hard foam that we sometimes see. It seems like really nice rubber tires. And then finally, we have a true aluminum 4-inch spinner drilled for a two blade. And this is nice. This is a nice spinner. However, if you decide to use this one, I'm not sure if I'm going to use it. I think I might be going for a bigger spinner myself. But this is one of the upgraded pieces of this kit. A true all-aluminum 4-inch spinner drilled for a two-blade. And it comes with the center bolt on there as well. Now let's get to the brand new retracts. These are branded Seagull model retracts, but we will see when we open up the controller. These are very familiar looking retracts. They look very similar to the same ones that I have in my LA7. We see here we'll pull out the JP retracts controller. So these struts do have a little bit of give in there, so that's nice. There's a nice spring in here, very nice and sturdy, well constructed. And we see that these each retract will connect into that control box, and so you'll need one channel from the control box into your receiver. And just like last time, we have all the control rods needed wrapped in one place, and they have all of the connections on them already. So it's nice that we don't have a bag of connectors that we have to kind of fish through. So let's put all of these kind of smaller accessories on the table and do a really nice slow panning shot of everything up and close. We've got the nose cone, the canopy hatch, the JP retrack units, the JP retracts, the new tires, the new aluminum wheels, tail wheel, bits and accessories, the pilot, and then we have the motor mount, the electric motor mount kit back there. But then in the front on the left, we see that new piece to cover up the bottom of the tail wheel. It's a fully built out wooden piece that gets mounted into the bottom of the fuselage. I've saved the fuselage for last, and I was really excited to see what this looks like. Even though, again, I've built Parastroika before, but I want to see this chrome covering. It's nicely wrapped, and it's the wrapping's held together with a rubber band on the back of the fuselage, so let's undo that and pull it out of the wrap. So it's neat, whatever covering they used, it kind of gives that brushed aluminum feel, which is exactly what race number 86 looks like. So I'm really happy with this. It looks cool. And in fact, for you watching the video, you can probably, it's reflecting all of the lights in my room. So sorry about that. But here we see the bottom of the fuselage, and we see that big open area at the bottom of the tail wheel for that new built up piece. And we have the hatch here, and in case, it took me a while to realize this, but to open this up, you need to push it forward just like that, and then it pops up. So you might need to get maybe a credit card, or if you have nice fingernails, you can get in there and just push it forward, slide it forward, and it pops out. So let's look inside. This is where your batteries will go, your servos will be mounted, and et cetera, et cetera. Finally, I wanted to show you the included graphics that comes with this, with some Seagull model decals, but the race number 86 and the Czech Mate logo. Thanks for tuning in. I wanted to show you guys exactly everything that comes with this new version of the Yak 11 Reno Racer from Seagull Models. As soon as I saw this plane go up for sale, I pre-ordered it at Legend Hobby and just got it yesterday, threw it out of the box and filmed this for you because I wanted to show everyone what's new, what all comes inside this box, and what you're getting into if you're thinking about building this ARF. So we're going to end this video with some panning shots of the fuselage to just give you some really clear and up close detailed views of the fuselage. We will see you in a week or two for the beginning of the build series of race number 86 Czech Mate, the Seagull Models Yak 11 Reno Racer.